Hello. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to configure the Cogent DataHub to read data from a database. So let's get started. From the Properties window, we click on the Database icon. And to read data, we want to configure a query to an ODBC database. So we choose to click on the Configure button. Now, the first thing we need to do in this interface is connect to our database. If we haven't already done so, you can open the DSN administrator and configure a DSN entry for the database. In this case, I'm using a MySQL database, so I've already got my DSN configured. And all we do is, from the drop-down list, we choose our DSN and click Connect. And you can see our status tells us that we have successfully connected to our database. Now the next step is to define our database query. I'm going to give this query a label, call it My Query 1. And to save time, I'm going to paste in a very simple SQL statement. What this is doing, I have a select star or select all from a table called process 1 and order the results by a point index field or column, arrange them in descending order, and then return the first item in the list. And because this is descending order, this will result in returning a single row, which would be the last row to be added to the table. So I am going to click Submit just to check my syntax. And you can see that I didn't get an error message, so everything's okay. Now, the row of data that we're returning in this query, I want to parse this and create a data point within the data hub. So I'm going to click one point per row. And the name of the data point is actually defined in a column called PTName within my table. The value is defined in a column with a header called ptValue, the timestamps in the ptTime column, and the quality in the ptQuality column. And this point that I'm going to be creating, I want it to be in a new data domain within the data hub that I'm going to call test. So if I now click on Create, you can see we've created a configured action that's connecting to the MySQL Cogent database, and here's our query statement. But you'll notice we haven't configured a trigger condition yet, or a trigger event. So let's go to step 3. A trigger is how we tell the data hub to execute the query. For this demo, I'm just going to simply say that I want this to fire every 5 seconds. So I click on Modify, and you see we've updated our configured action to pull in one row from our table and parse it into a data point and execute this query every 5 seconds. So I'm happy with this. I'm going to click Apply. If we come back to Properties window, if we select Show Diagnostics in Script Log and then apply that change, we can open the script log, and there you'll see is the definition of our query statement. And at the bottom, you'll see we're now executing every 5 seconds, we're executing our query over to the database. If we come back and take a look at the data within the data hub, here's our new test domain, and within it, here's our data point that we read from the point name column, and its value is being updated every 5 seconds. We're doing a new query, and it's taking the last row to be added to the table, parsing that and getting a point name, timestamp, quality, and value. Now, before we go on, I want to come back to my query interface, and I'm going to show you something else. I'm going to duplicate this query. I'm going to select it and then press Create again, and I'm just going to change the label for it. And instead of returning a single row, I'm going to tell this query to return the last 10 rows in the column, in the table from my database. And instead of 1 point per row, I'm going to say that I want all 10 rows to be stored in a single point as a data set. And as a shortcut, I'm going to use the name I already have. So the new point that I want to create is still going to be in the test domain. It's going to be pid1.pv, and I'm just going to add .dataset to differentiate it from the first point that I created. So if I press modify on this and then press apply, you'll see over here in the script log, we now have two query statements executing every 5 seconds. One of them is returning one line, and that's being parsed into our single data point. And the other query is returning 10 rows of information that's being stored in a data point that represents those 10 rows as XML data. And let's just take a look at that. Here's our test domain. So our single point's being updated. And here is our data set, which represents 10 rows of data formatted in an SQL format. An XML format. Once we have the data within the Data Hub, we can do lots of interesting things with it. We can drag and drop the data out of the Data Hub into Excel and have the data update in Excel. We can use this in reports and analysis. We can share the data with OPC clients and servers. In this case, you can see I'm using an OPC Quick client to read the value of the point we read from our database. And you see the values being updated every 5 seconds. So we can share data from the database with OPC clients and servers. And here in DataHub WebView, you can see we're displaying the point data that we read from the database. There's our pid1.pv point. And in the filtered data table control, we are displaying the data set point that we created. So this is the last 10 rows of information being queried from the database on a 5-second cycle. So that shows you just some of the ways we can use data that we read from a database into the Cogent Data Hub using a simple and easy query interface. If you have any questions about this, you can get much more information in our online documentation that's available at www.cogentdatahub.com.